Home to the second biggest carnival celebration in the world, this city is the capital of the Atlántico department in northwest Colombia. Today we take a closer look at Barranquilla. Welcome to Earth from Space. Barranquilla, visible in grey, covers an area of around 155 square kilometers and is the fourth most populous city in Colombia, after Bogotá, Medellín, and Cali. The city of Barranquilla serves as a major trade center for Colombia, housing the largest port along the Caribbean Sea. Thanks to this famous port, Barranquilla earned itself the nickname Colombia's Golden Gate, or La Puerta de Oro de Colombia in Spanish. The city lies strategically next to the delta of the Magdalena River, one of the main rivers in Colombia. It flows northwards for around 1,500 kilometers through the west half of the country before emptying into the Caribbean Sea. This image, captured in March 2021, was taken just before the onset of the rainy season, which starts in April. Owing to large quantities of sediment, as seen by the extensive sediment plume and the brownish colors of its waters, the Magdalena requires frequent dredging of its main channel to allow access to Barranquilla's port for ocean-going vessels. The urban area of Barranquilla contrasts with the Cienaga Grande de Santa Marta, swampy marshes to the east, visible in dark green. Selected as a Ramsar site of international importance, this site is important for its mangrove ecosystem, which is the largest on the Caribbean coast of Colombia. It also serves as a habitat and winter breeding ground for several bird species. Other notable features in the image include the El Guajardo Reservoir, located around 50 kilometers southwest of Barranquilla. In addition to sewage discharges, the reservoir receives agricultural runoff, particularly during the rainy season. This can lead to states of eutrophication in the water that are often accompanied by blooms of harmful microorganisms, otherwise known as cyanobacteria. These types of algae, which are commonly present in freshwater and saline ecosystems, are most likely why the lake appears in emerald green in today's image. Satellite data from the Copernicus Sentinel-2 mission can track the growth and spread of harmful algal blooms. This is useful in order to alert and mitigate against damaging impacts for tourism and fishing industries.